Thank you so much. It's really very moving to stand here with a view of the Statue of Liberty. And it is really the reality of freedom that this country and this city represents for every immigrant and for every person who has been oppressed. And in this sense, one has to think of that great competition for the insignia of the United States. There were two finalists, the eagle and the design of Benjamin Franklin, of the staff of Moses. The eagle won, but the spiritual essence of freedom is this trek, this exodus out of oblivion into a new light. And I have to say that it's not by coincidence that the days of creation, the 7 days of creation, the fourth day is right in the middle. It's in the middle that God creates sun and the moon and the stars. It's a middle, and I think four represents really the middle because it also represents the summation of all numbers. 1, 2, 3, and 4 is 10, which means all the numbers. But the middle is the middle of a story, and I think it's important to think of four as entering into the middle of the story. We are not at the beginning, and we are not at the end. We are in the middle. And we're indeed in the middle of New York, and if I think of Ground Zero, which is inscribed in a quadrangle of four sides, I did think of four things that really touch on New York. Number one, the heroes who fell in the city, who represent all of us. Number one. Number two, the resurgence of life in the city. That's what New York is about. It's a light to humanity, to all of us. Three, the slurry wall, which is an eloquent piece of construction that speaks to the bedrock and stability in face of the attacks against democracy. And four, the Statue of Liberty, with its spiraling and dynamic movement, taking us beyond the quadrangles that stand all around us. So thank you very much.